everyone. I'm going to make a resin geode cake stand again, and this time I'm going to use some beautiful green blue colors. I'm also going to use a lot of sparkle because I love sparkle, and to create some nice effects I'm going to use the puddle technique again, what I also did with my other cake stands. So in this video I will show you the whole process of pouring in the mold, unmolding them, and of course I'm going to show the end result of the front and the back. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin like this one, or tutorials of acrylic, resin geodes and a lot more, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to make a resin geode cake stand again, and I'm going to use some nice blue green colors. And the first color I'm using is one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the mermaid. It's a nice blue green shade, very sparkly, so on the edge against the silicon barrier. So as a base I'm using an acetate sheet. It's heat resistant, more than plastic. And for the barriers I'm using a silicon rubber, and you can use these silicon rubbers more than once. If you want to know how I make the mold, then you can watch video 347. I will also include the link in the right corner. Then you can watch how I make the silicon barriers. So this color is a Bombay ink. It's the Baya Blue. And I also mixed one of my own pigments in it. I'm testing it. It's the Dazzle Gold. It's very sparkly. It's just like the Sparkle White I have, the same sparkle, but then in a gold, golden sparkle. So I'm going to fill the whole layer. The heat gun for the air bubbles. I'm using my heat gun a lot, no torch, because if I use a torch, then I have a risk that it gets too hot and the resin will stick to the silicon barriers. And for the silicon rubber, I have found a comparable silicon rubber for the people outside of Europe, because this silicon rubber is from Resin Pro and they don't ship to outside of Europe. So I found one that is almost the same. The link is in the description box. So if you're curious, please check out the description box. And also all the other materials I'm using you can find in the description box or at the end of the video. Again the heat gun. Now I'm starting with the petals. I'm starting with a nice green shade, and this is the Just Resin Breakfast at Tiffany's. In the middle, on top of the Baya Blue, and I made it very transparent, so only a few drops in the resin. And on top I'm using the Resin Pro white paste, and this way I'm building the puddle. And on top again the Baya Blue, the alcohol ink. And I push those colors to the outside to make the puddle larger. And I'm pouring from up high so that the stream is very thin, and that way it goes all the way through the colors to the bottom. Yeah, and I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro resin, and Yeah, with this resin I can pour up to 1 centimeter. So if I pour higher than 1 centimeter, then I have a risk that I have a lot of air bubbles. I don't want that. But also a risk that it doesn't set well enough. So these shapes, these geode shapes, will not be thicker than 1 centimeter. And it's a great resin. I also have a promo code for the Resin Pro company if you buy on the German or the UK website and you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount, so that's great. All the information to that is in the description box with the links to the websites. Again, the Baya Blue, but now a little bit darker. Also, in upcoming videos I will show my mixing process. I got some questions about that, how I mix my resin, but also how I mix the powders, the paste and the ink. So I'm going to show you that in one of my upcoming videos. Again, the breakfast at Tiffany's. A smaller puddle, the white on top. And now I'm using the Sparkle White in some clear, very sparkly, just like the Dazzle Gold I used in the Baya ink in the beginning. But this is clear with the Sparkle Gold, Sparkle White, sorry. Yeah, and I've used these silicon barriers for all my cake stands, and they work very well. I'm very pleased with this silicon rubber. And yeah, the leakage I had in my previous videos for the cake stands was that thin. You can take it very you can take it off very easy. Again, the Baya Blue in the middle. And the Sparkle Gold White. And hopefully I will have a nice backside so that this cake stand can be used on both sides. Yeah, and this resin is not food safe, so if it needs to be food safe, then you can make it with a food safe resin. Also, Resin Pro has a food safe resin. And what I also can do is add a clear layer of food safe resin on top of the shapes. Little bit of the white paste. Yeah, and these colors go very well together, very nice. So far, no leakage, what I can see. So hopefully turns out okay. Again, the Sparkle White in the middle to push the colors to the outside and to create a nice transparent center. Uh, And then I'm almost done, and I need to let this dry before I can take them out of the mold. So we are 1 hour later, and I wanted to show you a close-up because it changed very much. There you can see it, some nice blending of colors and some nice effects of the mermaid mica pigment. If you're interested in one of my natural mica pigments, I have listed them in my Etsy shop. The link to it is in the description box. And with some nice discounts. And they are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. She also has some nice discounts in her Etsy shop and free shipping above $35. So that's great. Also, the link to her Etsy shop is in the description box. So if you're curious or interested, please check out the description box below this video. So we are 24 hours later, and now I can take them out of the mold. So what I do is I push the silicon barrier to the outside, there you can see it, and I take it off, and it goes very easy. So again, to the outside, and then you can take it off, no problem. So I'm starting with the smaller one, push the acetate seed downwards, and then you can take your geode shape from the acetate seed. There you can see it. You need to be careful because they are still a little bit bendy. Now the larger one. And this side looks great, so hopefully the back side also looks nice. So now we can take a closer look. This one is great. I only have a little bit of a raised edge. And that is the backside. Very nice. With the breakfast at Tiffany's. A lot of sparkle in the middle. And a nice sparkle on the outside of the dazzle gold. Yeah, I like this very much. The larger one. There you can see it. Totally different effects. Now a closer look. This is the front side. Hopefully you can see the sparkle and the nice effects. But you can see I have a little bit of a raised edge. What I do is I take my paper nail file and very lightly I sand it. And because I also am going to add some gilding liquid on the sides, and almost no leakage with the silicon barrier, so that was great. There you can see the effects in the middle with the transparent center. This is a close-up of the backside. Yes, totally different effects. You can see the dazzle gold on the outside. It sparkles a lot. And the sparkle white in the middle. But I got some great effects. Very pleased with this cake stand. So the next thing I'm going to do is drill the holes, sand the sides a little bit, and then paint the edges with a liquid gilding paint. And yeah, I'm going to attach the hardware. So if you want to see how I put the hardware in, drilling the holes or paint the edges, then you can watch a video 348. I will also put a link in the right corner, but there I show you the whole process. So this is the end result, and this is the front side, so how I poured it. And I have it outside in the daylight, in the sun. Hopefully you can see the nice effects and the sparkle of the dazzle gold on the outside and the sparkle white in the middle. But I can't choose which side I like the most because I also like this. And in a minute I will show you the backside, a close-up of that. And I also like the backside. So yeah, that's nice about these cake stands. You can use it on both sides. Now some nice golden edge, there you can see it, and the golden hardware. Yeah, I'm very pleased with this cake stand. Nice colors. Now a little bit closer. Yeah, some great effects. There you can see the sparkle. But because of the sparkle, it's very difficult to film. So if you're interested in one of my art pieces, the only thing you need to do is send me an email. My email address is in the description box. And this is a close-up of the backside with the Breakfast at Tiffany's. Totally different effects, but also very beautiful. There you can see the rings with the nice, yeah, I don't know how you call this effect, but I think it's beautiful. Let me know what you think of this cake stand, if you like the front or the back, or both, or no side, it's also possible. Let me know in the comments. I would really like to know what you think of this cake stand. And yeah, very nice. Also on this side, a nice sparkle. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all, because that's very important. Then you will see all the videos I will upload to my channel. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. That would help my channel a lot. All the information about the website you can find in the description box. Also to my Etsy shop, Facebook page, Instagram, you name it. Amazon Influencer Store for the Netherlands, but also for the USA. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.